Today's video is brought to you by Card Kingdom. Hello everyone, it's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another instant deck deck, and today we have a really cunning modern deck. This is a deck that is a different kind of Zirda combo deck, also a very different style of Goblin Charbelcher combo deck, so smashing together a couple of like weird janky combos together in a really unique way, and this deck comes to us from Noble Rooster, so thank you so much to Noble Rooster for sending me a super sweet deck. And a quick reminder before we break down Zirda Staff Belcher for Modern. If you enjoy this deck and you want to see it made into videos, take a minute, click the like button, the subscribe button, leave a comment, anything you can do to support your deck, because whichever deck is most popular gets a shot at being made into videos next week. So Zirda Staff Belcher, it's a really unique deck. If you look at the whole deck, it's kind of a Jeskai control style shell, and really it is, but it has a really tricky, cool combo at the base of it. So first off, one of our most important pieces, Zirda the Dawnwaker. So this is our companion. It lowers the activated abilities that aren't mana abilities on our stuff, which is helpful. It does help some of our stuff. More importantly, Zirda is a creature that doesn't start in our deck, but we always have access to. That is the part of Zirda that we're really trying to abuse. The other abilities are nice, but mostly it's a creature that's always in hand, but can't be hit by discard or anything. So how are we abusing Zirda? And the answer here is Proteus Staff. So Proteus Staff is kind of this repeatable polymorph artifact. 3 mana to cast, 3 more to activate. You put a creature on the bottom of its owner's library, and then the creature's controller gets to reveal cards at the top of their library until they reveal a creature. That creature goes into play, and then you get to put the rest of the cards on the bottom of your library, all the revealed cards, in any order that you want to. So the idea here is we can get down Proteus Staff, we play Zirda, we activate Proteus Staff targeting Zirda. What this does is it puts Zirda on the bottom of our deck. It gives us Zirda back because we don't have any other creatures in our deck. So we're going to go through our entire deck, get Zirda. More importantly, it allows us to order our deck however we want to. We get our Zirda, like nothing happens essentially. It's there, it goes to the bottom, it comes back in by the time Staff resolves. So essentially this is, you get to reorder your library. So this allows us to stack our cards however we need them to set up our combo. What we're really setting up to win the game is Goblin Charbelcher. So what we're setting up is stacking all the lands in our deck at the bottom of our deck, Goblin Charbelcher on the top of our deck, and then Goblin Charbelcher also takes advantage of Zirda. Even though it's 4 to a cast, its 3 mana activated ability is reduced to 1, for 5 total mana, we can play Goblin Charbelcher, activate it, reveal cards down till we hit our first land, which we stacked on the bottom of our deck with Proteus Staff, and kill our opponent on the spot with like 25-30 damage from Goblin Charbelcher. So that is the main plan of the deck. Also worth mentioning that we can just use the Proteus Staff Zirda combo again and again and again while we're waiting to set up our combo to, like, let's say we need a counter spell or a removal spell. Proteus Staff on Zirda will find that because we get to reorder our deck every single turn. So we can keep doing this again and again and again because Zirda's going to keep coming back into play as the only creature to our deck. Otherwise, Teferi Time Raveler just protects us from instant speed interaction, counter spells on our Charbelcher or Proteus Staff, whatever. Then we have a bunch of counter spells which also help protect our combo. Mana Leak, Remand, Force of Negation. We get some early game cantrips to find our pieces, Opted Surrevisions to find our Proteus Staff, to find our Goblin Charbelcher when we need it. A bunch of removal spells, Path to Exile, Lightning Helix for the early game, Supreme Verdict for a sweeper, and then we have Astrolabe just to kind of fix our mana. It's mostly just a value card, and as you can see, because we don't have many permanents in our deck, it's just Astrolabe and Teferi, we very easily meet Zirda's restriction of all of our permanents having activated abilities. So in some sense, by just playing all spells, or primarily spells, it's pretty easy to have Zirda as our companion. As far as the mana base, most important land is Academy Ruins. We can use our Proteus Staff combo to tutor it to the top of our deck, get it in play, and then it gives us an answer to our opponent's answers. If our opponent, like, kills our Proteus Staff, we can just put it back on top of our deck, go back into our combo. Same with Goblin Charbelcher. Otherwise, a creature land, bunch of mana fixing stuff, fetch land, shock land, snow covered basics. In the sideboard, along with Zirda, we have a bunch more removal, some counter spells, Ashiok for graveyard hate, timely reinforcements, really good with Burn being like the top deck in the format right now. Very helpful in that matchup. And that is Zirda Staff Belcher for Modern. And that's been our instant deck for today. So thanks so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed the video, and I will talk to you soon. If you enjoyed today's deck, make sure to purchase it from our sponsor, Card Kingdom. For a limited time, you can get a Scoop Soldier sticker for free if you mention Scoop Soldier in your order notes during checkout. Thanks for watching the video! If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.